Hey, we are live again with another Wild Heritage episode of Barnyard with Becca, talking about probably some of our most famous animals here on the farm, our llamas, Boo and Aiden. Boo is named Boo because he was born on Halloween about 15 years ago, and he is completely white. So we named him Boo, and then Aiden is named after the little boy that actually witnessed Aiden's birth. So that's why they're named what they're named. Our llamas here are famous for giving llama kisses, but right now they're kind of occupied with their food and water, and they're curious about the camera. Llamas are extremely curious animals that get completely weirded out when anything changes. They are creatures of habit, literally the definition of. You move their water bowl, they're like, what happened? You feed them at a different time, something's wrong. They are very curious and dramatic creatures. So the phrase, save the drama for your llama, is pretty accurate. They have enough drama to go around. But we'll see if they come up to me later and demonstrate what a llama kiss is. But until then, I will just talk about what llamas are and some interesting things about them. So llamas are in the camel family. That's a question I get a lot of times from people out here, is are these guys related to horses or are they related to camels? And they are in the camel family. They're basically the camel of South America. They don't have a hump, but they are able to complete the same efficient fat use for energy and don't require much water. They also have the packing animal abilities of a camel, and people use them to get over the Andes Mountains. The Peruvian culture has utilized llamas as their packing animal and beast of burden throughout their history. A llama can carry up to about a fourth of its body weight on their back, and their toes look like two little hooks. I don't know if you can see it from the camera, but those are perfect for rock climbing. If you've ever done the rock climbing wall here, wouldn't it be great if you had hooks for hands and feet? That's what they've got, and so it makes it perfect for climbing rocky cliffs and mountains. But that being said, if somebody tries to load a load on a llama that they think is too heavy to bear, that drama comes back. They lay down and they spit until the owner would take off the weight that they needed to get back down to that fourth of their body weight. And our llamas are no exception to the drama. If you're wearing a hat, something's off. You're not a regular person. We're going to the other side. If our dog Izzy walks in front of them, they have to follow her the entire way. They are completely curious and like to know their bearings, but that makes them perfect guard animals. They are also shepherds. A lot of people in South America, and now it's trendy here too, have llamas as guard animals for their sheep and goats, because anything that's not belonging there, they will get rid of. We have witnessed our llamas do that. My father has actually witnessed Boo stomp out a skunk. That didn't end very well. But anything that is new, they will defend themselves and everybody else against. They have also been known to scare off coyotes and wild dogs. So they can get pretty aggressive to something that they think does not belong. Llamas also are pretty cool. A lot of people are like, what's the difference between a llama and an alpaca? Because they seem like similar animals, and they are cousins. They are in the same family, but alpacas are about half the size of a llama. Alpacas typically stand about 4 feet tall, and they weigh a lot less than llamas, as where llamas can stand like 6 feet tall, and they weigh about double of an alpaca. And the alpacas also have short pointy ears, as where our llamas, you can see, have really long round ears. And so that's how you can tell the difference between a llama and an alpaca. Also, you can look at their wool An alpaca has really, really fuzzy, dense wool like our sheep, but the llama has that long, fine wool. And that long, fine wool is really, really distinctive to them. Llama hair and llama wool product is really expensive and kind of considered luxury because it is lightweight and warm, which is something you don't get with sheep wool. Sheep wool is very heavy. If you've ever worn a sheep wool sweater, you pretty much only want that if it's under 30 degrees. But a llama wool sweater is lightweight yet still warm, so you don't feel so stuffy wearing it. It also is water repellent, which sheep wool is not as good at, but because these guys are made for the mountains that are often very misty and rainy, their wool is kind of like we talked about with the Scottish Highlanders, where the outside has so much oil on it that it's water repellent, and then the inside is what keeps them warm. So llama wool is really nifty. So llamas not only were used for packing animals, but also for their wool and also for their meat. We don't do that here so much in the Americas, but in South America, llama meat is a common thing that you would run across as well. So llamas' senses are super heightened as well, which is pretty unique to them. Their eyes have a rectangular pupil, kind of like you would see on a goat or a horse, and they're on the sides of their heads, and they can see pretty much peripherally around them like this without having to turn their heads. And you can kind of tell where a llama is looking by looking at the positions of their ears. It's really interesting. Boo is keeping an eye on us right now while he is eating his hay because one end of his ears is turned to us. So you can tell that he's using that eye and ear to figure out what's going on with us while they're minding their own business over there. So if you've come here to Heritage Farm and it's not feeding time, so they're not so interested in their food, you've probably received a llama kiss if they deemed you llama worthy. And so they come over and they do this kind of sniffing motion on your head and it tickles. What they're actually doing is grooming you. That is how llamas groom their young. Llamas cannot stick out their tongues. They can't physically stick out their tongues. So to groom their babies, they have to blow air on their hair to kind of blow out the dust. And so when the llamas come over to you and blow on your head, they're actually thinking you're dirty and you need cleaned. So that's what our famous llama kisses actually are. Also, you want to catch these llamas at a good time and win over their affection because llamas are known to hold grudges. They have great memories, and if you do something that they deem out of the ordinary and they don't like, they walk away from you. They'll pull their ears back, which is their sensory body communication motion for I'm about to spit. Now, our llamas don't spit a whole lot, but llamas are kind of famous for this spitting motion. And what they do actually is because they chew their cud, they are a ruminant, which means they chew their food once, they swallow it, grind it up in their stomach a bit, then they regurgitate it back to their mouth for a second chew, and then send it back to their stomach. But when a llama spits, it's actually that regurgitation back up of their food at the same time as a vocalization, and that is what causes them to spit. And that's why it's not just like saliva, it's literally ground up food that you get if a llama spits at you. So that's kind of their famous thing for what llamas do, but our llamas do not really spit. They have been used to people their whole life and are pretty well behaved, even though they are curious and slightly dramatic.